Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Chloe and today we are going to be discussing all the books that I plan to read in October. I say plan to read because I will most likely not get to all of these books. I do have a bit of a game plan, so obviously I will tell you guys about that. If you have seen any of my videos before, you might know that I am co-hosting a readathon called the Fright at the Movies Readathon, which is a month-long readathon inspired by horror movies and spooky Halloween movies. So I have put more focus on reading like thrillers or horrors or just books that are a bit more spooky. Funny thing is, I always say that thriller and horrors are like my favourite genre. However, I don't read a lot of it. It's just when I do read it, I really enjoy it. And I think it's because like there's a part of my brain that's very sadistic and it likes kind of, you know, those not very nice things. So my game plan is basically to stick to my own category. There's four co-hosts, including myself. We have a category each, which is inspired by either like a horror movie genre or like a spooky movie genre. And then everything else will just be a case of like as and when, if I can get to them. The first category, which is my own category, is the slasher category. I love slashers. I love watching people get stabbed. Yeah, just so that you're aware. I mean, I'm sure that no one's going to get confused, but just in case, I don't like watching people getting stabbed in real life. It's only in the films. Also, because most of the characters are stupid, so it's kind of like you deserve it anyway. The first prompt for the slash category is to read a recommendation. This is based off of the movie Scream, which is, by the way, my favourite horror movie. The book that I will be reading for this prompt is actually a recommendation from one of my co-hosts, and that is Ray. Ray is very lovely. In the early stages of planning this readathon, we were talking about books, and she essentially mentioned this book and said that the author is usually compared to Stephen King, but is the Swedish version. She recommended that I read Let the Right One In by Jon Ivar Lindqvist, I think is how you pronounce it. At least that's how I pronounce it in Danish. I don't know what it's like in Swedish. All I know is this is about vampires. This is about Oscar, who is a 12-year-old boy who lives with his mum on a housing estate, and then one day this girl moves into this housing estate and she's a bit weird. She's got some stuff going on. She just seems a bit freaky. And I think the gist of the plot is she's a vampire. Something happens with that. I don't know what, because obviously I haven't read it yet. The next prompt is to read a book that you are most excited for. The book that I have chosen for this was for the longest time one of the books that I was most, at least like the 2021 release that I was most excited for, and I am still very excited for it. However, I will say that there's been some not great reviews of it, and I've heard some of my friends saying that they didn't really enjoy it and that it was a disappointment. I'm hoping that won't be the case for me. Hopefully I will be the exception. That book is Survive the Night by Riley Sager. Riley Sager is probably my favourite thriller author, or at least he is up there with John Mars, even though I haven't really read many of John Mars's books, but those two men are my two favourite thriller authors, I think, of all time. I've enjoyed every single book that he's written, so I'm slightly worried about this. We will see what happens. It's about a girl who is basically in a car with someone that she thinks is a serial killer. That's the second book. I now realise that I am so unprepared for this video because I don't actually have a book for the next prompt. This next prompt is a book that's chosen by fate. I have not done that yet, so we're gonna do it on camera. I'm basically, for this prompt, I am gonna go through my thingy mabobs on Libby, and I'm gonna find what books that I wanna add, and then I'm gonna use a random number generator, I think, to decide which book. I'm gonna go into my list of books that I want to read, and I think I'm just gonna tag them or something like that. Do you know what? I'm just gonna be so random with this. I'm literally just gonna pick books and I'm gonna be like, that one maybe. So this one, I don't know what it's about. I think it's about someone that goes to prison. I've never watched The Living Dead. Never watched The Living Dead. Probably should, to be fair. I'm gonna add that in. There's also this one, also about vampires. Just adding random ones that I think are kind of spooky or whatever. So that's to do with Dracula's Child. It must be spooky, right? This person has weird fucking eyes. I'm gonna add that in. I like this cover and it says something to do with a woods. So that must be spooky. A new release, which I honestly did not think would be this easy to get on Libby. So we'll add that. The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. I don't know if it'd be stupid for me to try and read this. because it's a classic, but I'm gonna add it anyway. My Lovely Wife. I've heard good things about Samantha Downing. I don't know which one of her books it was that people liked, but The Harpy, this is also supposed to be slightly weird, so I'm gonna add that. Station 11, it is about a pandemic. That's scary. And I know from personal experience. This random one that is about a witch. It's about a witch, so it's going in. I was meant to read The Push in September, that's not happening. So therefore it goes on this list as well. Basically, September, I believe, is Roald Dahl month. My friend has been reading loads of Roald Dahl books, so that's been making me want to read more, so I'm gonna add this just anyway. I honestly, I wanna add one more, I think. I'm gonna add, I don't know. I'm gonna add Watch Over Me by Nina Lacour. Is that how you say her name? I don't know. Anyway, we've got 14 books in there now. I'm gonna get a random number generator and basically put in 14, and whichever number I get is gonna be the book that I read. It's on 1 to 14. Let's go. I got 13. I can't remember which book that was. Good, I have the list. Oh shit. Well, it's been put backwards. The thing is, I could be a cheater and say it's James and the Giant Peach. But that was the 13th one I put into the list, so technically it's number 13. So, therefore I'm going to be reading James and the Giant Peach. That is the one that is chosen by fate. I'm now finished with this stupid prompt that I didn't plan for. Ah, James and the Giant Peach. There we go, peeps. So, the next prompt is inspired by Halloween, and it was inspired by Laurie Strode, who I think is the one of the coolest final girls in the history of horror films. So therefore the prompt is to read a book with a kick-ass female character. For this prompt, I'm going to be reading Coraline by Neil Gaiman. This will be the third time I've read it, I think. I just absolutely love this edition of it. I've also got the Graveyard book in this edition, and it's just, it's so gorgeous and I love it. And Coraline is one of my favourite middle grade books of all time. I just, and it's a comfort reread, to be quite honest. Even though it's creepy, it's kind of comforting in a way because I'm messed up. But yeah, that is the book I'm going to be reading for this. I don't think we need to dispute the fact that Coraline is a kick-ass female protagonist. She is just super cool and she is a great role model for young girls, boys, non-binary people, everyone. Everyone should try and be like Coraline. Don't sew buttons into your eyes. Let's move on to the next category. That is psychological. This is also a very fun category. So the first prompt is for Silence of the Lambs. It's inspired by Dr. Hannibal Lecter, who is a psychologist, that's what he is. He is a smart man. He's a very smart man. And therefore the prompt for this was to read a non-fiction book. So the book that I ended up deciding to read is Boy Erased by someone that I can't remember his name and I feel really bad. This is basically like a memoir kind of thing. It's basically about this man who, when he was a teenager, I believe he was sent to a conversion therapy camp by his parents because they found out that he was gay. And that is just, the idea of anyone ever being sent anywhere to try and erase something that's so integrally a part of them, that's scary in itself. Like, it doesn't matter what it is. If it's a big part of your personality and someone's trying to, like, erase that, that's fucking scary, man. That is so scary. It's just a really scary topic. I think, personally, I watched the film that was inspired by this book. It was really, it was moving, it was sad, it was just, like, all the emotions, you know? So I thought I would like to read the book that inspired it. The next prompt is for The Shining, and that was to read a book with an unreliable narrator. The Shining isn't actually written from Jack Torrance's perspective. I don't even think it's a first person perspective. However, Jack Torrance plays such a big role that I thought it was all right to kind of transfer that into a first person narrative. If he was the narrator, then he would definitely be unreliable. We'll just say it like that. So the book that I decided to read for that is a book that I've heard about for about a year, I think, and I've really wanted to read it. It is Harrow Lake by Kat Ellis. This is also super perfect for this readathon because it is about someone who goes back to The town where her dad directed a cult classic horror movie. So it really fits in with the horror movie theme, and I just knew I had to get this onto my TBR somewhere. So I saw that someone had read this on Instagram. I asked them, could you say that the narrator is an unreliable narrator? And they said yes. So therefore, this is gonna fit that prompt, and I'm super excited. This has got sprayed edges. I love it, it's so cute. It's got Creepy Man on the front. I can't really say much else, but I'm excited. Next prompt is for Get Out. This is the film that I haven't seen yet. Shock horror, I know, I need to watch it. The prompt is to read a book by a BIPOC author. So I have got a couple of books throughout this TBR that are written by BIPOC authors, but this is the one that I've decided to choose for this prompt, and it is Legendborn by Tracy Dion. I'm just very excited for this. This has got secret societies, it's kind of inspired by Merlin and the Knights of the Round Table, Arthur, legends, all that stuff. It's got magic, it is not quite like horror or anything like that, it's middle grade and it's fantasy, it's kind of like urban fantasy, I guess. But also kind of like, I feel like it will have spooky, magic-y kind of things going on. Next prompt is for Psycho, and it's a book written before 1970, so before the 70s, and that is because Psycho, the film, also the book, because it's inspired by a book, but the film Psycho, which people most commonly know, is, I think it was released in the 1960s at some point, I can't remember when, but it was before the 70s. So therefore, I wanted to have a prompt where it gave you a choice to be able to read a classic or to read a more modern classic or just to read a book that, you know, is slightly older than a lot of the ones that people usually have on their TBR. So I actually have two books for this prompt. I don't know which one I'm gonna read because I want to read both of them. So if I can read both of them, I will. And those two books are Frankenstein by Mary Shelley, a classic everyone knows, and Dracula by Bram Stoker, also another classic. These two editions are just the cheap editions that I could get, and they're ugly as all hell, but it's fine. Luckily, these are relatively short. I think this is like under 200 pages or something. This is under 300 pages, which makes me very happy. But they are kind of like the two options that I have for this. As I said, I'm gonna try my best to read both of them because I really want to, but I might just end up transferring one of them onto my TBR for November. And I don't think I need to explain. Frankenstein's about a creepy Frankenman put together from dead body parts. Dracula is about Dracula, a vampire. So we're on to the next category, and that is the paranormal category. And the first prompt is for the Blair Witch Project. And because the Blair Witch Project is essentially about, it's all centered around the myth of the Blair Witch, right? So therefore, our prompt is to read a book that features an urban legend or is like a retelling of some kind. So the book that I decided to pick for this, which is very actually, it's very interesting that it's coming straight after Dracula because it's actually a retelling of the Bride of Dracula, the Dracula's Bride, I don't actually know. A Dowry of Blood by St. Gibson. I don't really have much to say about this aside from the fact that it is something to do with vampires. Apparently it's got depiction of an abusive relationship, and it's been done well according to certain people. I'm really interested to see what happens with this, and it's to do with vampires. So once again, vampires are cool, therefore I want to read it. It's taken Bookstagram and Booktube by storm, so I just wanted to get my hands on it, and I did, and now I'm gonna read it. The next prompt is for The Exorcist. If you didn't know, The Exorcist is about this little girl called Reagan who gets possessed by a spirit, a demon, some kind of thing, and needs to be exorcised. The prompt for this is to read a book with a supernatural being. The book that I've decided to go with is Once Again Vampires. The book that I'm going to be reading for this prompt is Fangs, which is about a relationship between a vampire and a werewolf, and it's supposed to be really cute. It's a graphic novel. I'm just very excited for this. I think it's going to be an easy read, and it's just it's also gorgeous because it's like cloth bound, it's got black sprayed edges. The next prompt is for Child's Play, which is the film that features the very famous Chucky, and in the film the little kid basically has been wanting to get this Chucky doll for the longest time. So the prompt is to read a book that has been on your TBR for the longest time. And the book that I chose for this is technically not been on my TBR for the longest time, but it's the book that I've been consistently wanting to read for the longest time. And that is Ace of Spades. I still don't know all that much about it. I just know it's been compared to Get Out. It's been compared to, like, Gossip Girl to a certain extent. And it's set at a private academy. It's got conversations about racism and about wealth, I believe, as well. And it's also got this person that's mysteriously sending texts about secrets and stuff like that. So I'm just very excited for this. I think that this is going to have very dark undertones, but it's going to be very interesting and very important read. And I'm just very, 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 very excited for it. The next prompt is for It, which is one of my favourite horror films of all time, the 2017 part one of It. The part two was just so long, and there's just something about not seeing the kids. Like, the kids are the thing that really gives it the charm. The Losers Club are awesome. The prompt is actually inspired by The Losers Club, and therefore it is to read a book featuring a group of kids. And the book that I want to get to for this, I don't know if I actually will, because it is a massive book. It is the book itself, the book that inspired the movie. It is It. I basically have this ongoing thing. I say ongoing, it's only happened twice, where I reread this every second year. But it might end up slipping into November because it is such a big book and I've got other books that I really want to get to. And I think November I'm going to really just, like, chill the fuck out with reading. The only thing is that the first two times, like the two times that I've read this, it's taken me months to read it. I'm thinking because I read a lot more books now that I could get through it quicker, but I really don't know. However, despite the chunkiness of this book, I just absolutely love it. There's something about The Losers Club that it just, I absolutely adore them. There's certain things in it that are a bit messed up and a bit unnecessary. I love this book. It will always have a place in my heart. So I really want to get to this. So now we are on to the final category. And this is the family faves category. This is inspired by some of our favourite Halloween movies that you would watch with kids. And it was particularly created for a certain someone. If you know the person, you will know who it is. Not naming any names though. No, I'm just kidding. I absolutely love these films as well. That's why we've got this as well, because we absolutely love these films. And the first film is Coraline. Classic. Everyone loves it. It's one of those films that, like, instantaneously became a classic and everyone started loving it. So I'm very excited that we have this on the list. And the prompt is inspired by Coraline's luxurious blue hair. So we want you to read a book that has blue on the front cover. Originally I was going to pick Coraline for this, but then I realised I had another book that fit the prompt a lot more that I do really want to get to. That book is actually going to be another graphic novel, and it is Something is Killing the Children. This is, as I said, a graphic novel. This has got multiple volumes. This is the first volume, so I've not read it before. And I'm very excited. As you can see, it's a very, very blue cover. And I just feel like this is going to have such great spooky vibes. I've heard that it's got similar vibes to Stranger Things, and I love that show, so this is gonna be very cool. The next prompt for this category is inspired by The Nightmare Before Christmas. I love this film so much. I've got this. I've also got Mr. Oogie Boogie over here. I've also got, shit, what's his name? Barrel. I think it's Barrel, this one. I can't wait to rewatch it as well. I'm super excited. The prompt for this film is to read a book that's set during Halloween or Christmas. It's actually a kind of difficult prompt to fulfill, just because, like, there's not that many books that are necessarily, like, specifically set in Halloween or Christmas. However, I did manage to find one, and this actually is very funny because it kind of is inspired by another film that's also on this list. And it is Hocus Pocus and the all-new sequel. And I really don't know much about this. All I know is that it kind of rewrites the original film and then visits the family members of Max and his girlfriend. You know, the two of the main characters. They end up getting together. They have kids and it's like following their kids or something like that. And it's set on Halloween, so that's why I picked it. And I feel like it would just be a fun, easy book to read. So that's why I picked that. And then the next film is The Addams Family, and the prompt for that is to read a book that's in a series. And the book that I've chosen for this is A Court of Frost and Starlight, which is the kind of like novella, like short book that is between A Court of Wings and Ruin and A Court of Silver Flames. Honestly, this is a lower priority for me. I don't know if I'll actually get to it, but I just thought, you know, I'll throw it on there. I'm excited to get to it. It's part of a series. Everything's good. The final prompt is for Hocus Pocus, and the prompt is to read a book that is about sisters or features sisters or whatever. And that is because obviously the three of the main characters are the Sanderson sisters in Hocus Pocus. They're probably the most iconic sisters ever. I have actually not decided 100% what I'm going to read for this. My main thinking is that I'm going to read Sadie, which is a book about a sister that goes missing and some things to do with the true crime podcast, and those elements just sound really interesting to me. So I think that's what I'm gonna go with. I do have a handful of other things that I might pick instead, but I think I'm gonna say Sadie for now. And that was the end of this video. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I hope you found it interesting hearing what books I plan to read for this readathon. If you are planning on taking part in the readathon, make sure to tell me down below and say what books you're planning on reading. You can also check out our Instagram. Everything will obviously be linked down below. And you can let us know over there by sharing the prompt graphics that we've done for the story, so you can add in your stories what TBR you have made for yourself. I will see you in my next video.